we speak about the Minsk agreement currently, how popular, especially in the meeting of the foreign ministers of the European Union, is this idea pushed by Moscow as well, that both sides are not keeping to the agreement?
When it comes to the Minsk agreement and its implementation, what's important for us is the official assessment provided by the OSCE and by the Special Monitoring Mission. And obviously we listen very carefully to our partners from Germany and from France. And what's important at this stage is not pointing fingers at each other, but making sure that the agreements are implemented. That's very important. We hear different views, obviously, but I personally really don't jump to any conclusions based on one or other information. We need to have an assessment which is objective, and for this we have created the OSCE mission. But there should be no speculations about any alternatives. There is a Normandy group, there are Minsk agreements, and there is this process, and this process has to be implemented.
How it is connected to the sanctions on Russia and to the meeting which we are expecting as well, to reviewing them?
Well, European Union made it very clear that we will review our sanctions policy on Russia with regard to the implementation of Minsk agreements, and therefore I expect a very detailed discussion on this subject closer towards the end of this year.
You always say that there is a lack of the strategic vision on the solution in the Russian aggression conflict in Ukraine, but what could be this strategic decision, and especially you are pushing and giving some clear answers?
Indeed, I have a very strong views on this, and I make my views known to my partners. Simply, I think we spend too much time discussing the details and too little time discussing the strategy. And first of all, what is our offer for Ukraine? Where do we want to see Ukraine in 5-10 years from now? What is the European Union ready to offer to Ukraine? And second, Ukrainian people have come out and have protested in Maidan because they wanted to improve the way the country, the state functions. They want to see less corruption. They want to see better protection of their rights, independent judiciary. They want to see, obviously, economic progress. And I think European Union should be more visible and more active on that part. I mean, we've spent hours and hours discussing Minsk and discussing the implementation and violation of ceasefire. But I would wish to see European Union in the center of the reforms effort. It was the Ukrainian citizens who were waving European Union's flags in Maidan. That means the European Union is and should act as a model. Slovakia is a success story, but we would hardly be so successful if it was not for the strong assistance from the European Union. The countries of the Western Balkans are guided, are assisted in their reforms effort by the European Union. So we must not let Ukraine alone in this effort.
When you mean about the clear support and of the reforms, what is that? How to be concrete?
I do not deny that there is a lots of efforts on the side of Ukrainian government, Ukrainian parliament, but I think we need to see a clear vision, clear strategy, comprehensive plan of reforms. When you know that step number one is this one, that step number two is that one, step number three, so that every citizen understands why these laws are adopted. They should understand that it's not immediately improving their life, but it's changing the society for better. So this effort must be coordinated and must be prioritized and put into a framework. And here I really believe is a role for the European Union to do that. So that, and I think it would help your government. And European Union has all the know-how, has all the structures, knowledge and funds for this. So instead of bold statements in favor of Ukraine, I would rather wish to see more concrete action to help you and your country and your people.
And what Ukraine can do in this regard, that who should be with the initiator?
Obviously, the bulk of the work is on Ukrainian government, on Ukrainian parliament, on Ukrainian people. Obviously, no one can do your homework for you, but I want you to feel assisted by the European Union, and that people have confidence that this process it's not only about raising taxes and raising the prices of different services, but it's a process that has a clearly defined goal, which is the better functioning state.